Good day everyone, welcome to the lecture session on Introduction to Power Electronics. Myself Lakshman, Assistant Professor, Department of Electrical Engineering, Raju Gandhi University of Knowledge Technologies, Basa. In this lecture session, I shall give you a brief introduction to Power Electronics, a course that is being offered to BTech Trivili students. In this session, we shall discuss necessity of power electronics, definition of power electronics, applications of power electronics, advantages and disadvantages of power electronic circuits, syllabus that is going to be covered in this course. Why power electronics? In order to explain the necessity of power electronics, let me quote few examples of power electronics applications. Firstly, let me consider an example of power semiconductor drives, in which usually we are required to control speed of a motor. I have considered induction motor in this particular example, speed of which can be controlled by supplying it with variable voltage and variable frequency supply. However, at input side, that is at supply means, we have fixed voltage and fixed frequency AC. There is a mismatch between source availability and load requirement. This problem can be addressed by power electronics. Power electronics circuit can be used to bridge this gap between source and load. A two-stage power electronic converter is considered as a solution to this problem. AC to DC converter to convert AC supply from grid into the DC at the DC link, and DC to AC converter to convert DC at link into required AC. This way one can control the output voltage of the DC to AC converter, thus can control the speed of induction motor. Let us consider one more example, that is electric vehicle. In electric vehicle, speed of vehicle can be controlled by an electric motor. So I have considered again induction motor as a motor to drive the vehicle, speed of which can be controlled by supplying it with AC variable voltage and variable frequency AC. However, in electric vehicle, source available is battery which can supply DC power. There is a mismatch between source availability and load, and this gap can be bridged with power electronic converter. An inverter is considered in this application, which can convert DC available at battery into required AC, so as to control the speed of induction motor, thus can control the speed of electric vehicle. In order to explain the necessity of power electronics, let me also quote two examples from renewable energy sources applications. Consider wind and grid integration. Usually, at wind power station, that is at the output terminals of the wind generator, we have variable voltage and variable frequency AC, and at grid we have fixed voltage and fixed frequency type AC. There is a mismatch between these two, that is wind generator and the grid. There is a clear mismatch. They cannot be integrated directly. Instead, we can bridge this gap using power electronic circuit. A power electronic circuit with two stage converters is considered as a bridge between wind and grid. In this particular example, AC to DC converter here to convert AC supply from the wind into a DC at the link and DC to AC converter to convert DC available at the link into required AC. And here one has to ensure that output at DC to AC converter will have same voltage and same frequency as that of the grid. Thus, one can synchronize wind generator with the grid using power electronic circuit. Let me also consider one more example from renewable energy applications, that is solar PV system integration with the grid. Solar PV system output terminals will have variable DC kind of supply, and this output power from the solar PV system is highly uncertain, that depends on climatic conditions such as light intensity and temperature and so on. So output power available at solar PV panel is highly uncertain, and that is variable DC type. And coming to grid, we have fixed voltage and fixed frequency AC. There is a mismatch between these two. They cannot be integrated directly. Instead, we can use a power electronic circuit to bridge gap between these two. A DC to DC converter in cascade with DC to AC converter is considered as a bridge between these two. DC to DC converter to convert DC from solar PV into a fixed DC at the link, a DC link, that is at the capacitor, and DC to AC converter to convert DC available at link into required AC. And once again, one has to ensure that output terminals of DC to AC converter we have a fixed voltage and fixed frequency as that of the grid. In fact, the value of voltage and frequency should be same as that of the grid. This way one can synchronize grid with the solar PV system, and power electronics can be used for this objective. So let me also quote a few more examples from power systems. Let us consider a power system in which source is supplying power to the load. Usually we expect source to supply entire active and reactive power required by load. However, if we can reduce the reactive power supplied by the source to the load, if we can reduce burden, reactive power supply burden on the source, we can improve the power factor. I mean to say that if some amount of reactive power required by load is supplied by some other alternative source other than the source, then net reactive power supplied by source will be reduced. So the power factor of the source will be improved, right? So as active power is more and reactive power is reduced, so the power factor of the source can be improved this way. We can also regulate the output voltage by using reactive power control, and this objective can be achieved through a static wire compensator. There are two kinds of static wire compensator that are very popular. The first one, shunt wire compensator. The second, series wire compensator. In this example, shunt type static VR compensator is considered. A capacitor can be connected in shunt to the line through a coupling transformer. Here, the capacitor can supply some amount of reactive power to the load. Thus, burden on source can be reduced. However, if one wants to control the reactive power supplied by the load so as to regulate the output voltage and also to improve the power factor from source side, so we can incorporate power electronic components, power electronic circuit. A simple triac, anti-parallel connection of thyristors or otherwise can be considered and can be introduced into the system, this turn on turn off condition of this portion, that is this track, can be controlled in such a way that the reactive power, the capacitance connected to the value of capacitance connected to the line in shunt can be controlled. Therefore, the reactive power supplied by capacitor also can be controlled so as to regulate the output voltage. In case if load is supplying reactive power, there must be a sink to receive or to absorb that reactive power. An inductor can be considered for this purpose. Inductor can be connected in shunt through coupling transformer to receive the excess reactive power supplied by the load, so that that is not entered into the source. Okay, the active power is more compared to the reactive power, power factor would be more. However, if one wants to control the inductance or inductor value so as to regulate the reactive power and to regulate the output voltage and improve the power factor, so we can also introduce triac in series with the inductor. By controlling turn on and turn off condition of this triac, one can vary the inductance that is connected across this line. So this way one can improve the performance, one can improve the power factor of the power the system, and also can regulate the output voltage. Let me also quote one more example from power system. A non-linear load required to be supplied from AC mains. Usually non-linear load required, so non-linear type of current from the source. For example, let me consider this kind of rectangular pulse current is required by the load. And if you connect AC mains directly to the load, the current supplied by AC mains is going to be non-linear, thus it introduces harmonics into the AC mains that affects on the performance of AC mains, that results in poor performance of AC mains, and also the poor performance of the loads that are connected to the AC mains. This problem can be addressed by power electronics. Again, a shunt active filter can be introduced into the system, so which can supply the harmonic content required by the load, and source will contribute only the sinusoidal component, that is fundamental component of the load. By introducing this shunt active filter, the harmonic current required by load can be supplied by only shunt active filter, and source would supply only the fundamental component, which is pure AC. So there are no harmonics are introduced into the system by using this shunt active filter. So though there is no impact negative, I mean there is no negative impact on AC mains. Thus, power electronics can also use it to improve performance of an electrical system. From the above examples, we can say that power electronics can bridge the gap between source and the load and can improve the performance of the system. The basic objective of power electronic circuit is to convert power from source to load and transfer power from source to load and control it. Not only conversion from DC to AC or AC to DC, we also need to control its frequency and magnitude, and that can be achieved. So that can be achieved by a control circuit. So objective of the control circuit in this particular power electronic circuit is to control the power electronic converter so that it can convert and it can control the flow of energy. The basic purpose of the power train circuit is to bridge the gap between source availability and load requirement, and also to improve the performance of electric circuits. And role of control circuit here is to control the power electronic circuit to control to regulate the power flow, and also to convert the power flow, to convert the power from input to the load. So one can define power electronics as a technology that deals with efficient control and conversion of electrical energy. The evolution of power electronics, mainly due to advancements in power semiconductor technology and need of efficient and reliable control and conversion of electrical energy. And power electronics usually uses components such as power semiconductor switches, power diode, SCR, power BJT, power MOSFET, IGBT, and so on. And it can also use as energy storage elements like inductor and capacitors. Usually resistors are not recommended to be used in power electronic converter circuits. Apart from the above, we can also use other components such as transformers, and we need to use control circuit to control the operation of the converter. So as the components that are involved in power electronic converters are associated with the low power losses, like power switch, power converter, power semiconductor switches, inductors, capacitors. So all these are associated with the low power losses, low amount of power losses. Thus, power electronics converters, so they usually they are more efficient. So that is the why in definition it is mentioned that it deals with the efficient control and conversion. So power electronics is a technology that deals with efficient control and conversion of electrical energy. So let me also mention few more applications of power electronics. With respect to industrial and home appliances, power electronics are used for heating and lighting applications, induction heating applications, UPS, lamps, and motor drives. In power systems, power electronics are used for HVDC transmissions and flexible AC transmission systems. It can also be used in electric vehicle applications for electrical ignitions and battery chargers, energy management. With respect to renewable energy sources, it is used to integrate solar or wind or both together to with the grid. For solar and wind integration with the grid, power electronics is used, and it plays major role in integration of renewable energy sources with the existing grid. And there are many more applications of power electronics. So coming to advantages of power electronic circuits are highly efficient, as they use low loss components such as inductor, capacitor, and power semiconductor switches. As there are no mechanical parts are involved in power electronic converters, so they are highly reliable, they have long life, less maintenance, they have flexibility in operation, they will have fast dynamic response usually. When compared to the mechanical switches such as relays and circuit breakers, these can be operated at high frequency in the range from kilohertz to megahertz. They have power electronic converters are small in size, and they have less weight, so installation is very easy and less costly. However, power electronic circuits suffers from one of the major disadvantage, that is power electronic converters have tendency to generate harmonics in the supply system as well as in the load circuit. However, this problem also can be addressed with the power electronics again. coming to the syllabus coverage, in unit 1, we shall cover power semiconductor devices, where we shall discuss power diode, power MOSFET, IGBT and SCR. In SCR, we shall discuss characteristics of ideal switch first, and then we shall also discuss characteristics of practical switches like power diode, power MOSFET, power BJT, IGBT and SCR, so on. So we shall also discuss the control circuits for turn on and turn off condition of these switches, so such as gate drive circuits for MOSFET and IGBT, and we shall also discuss switches in thyristor family. Thyristor is one of the major switch that is used in designing power electronic circuits in power system applications. So we shall discuss that also in detail, and few more switches in that particular thyristor family. In unit 2, we shall discuss a rectifier. Rectifiers are so AC to DC converter. Basically, input side we have AC and that is converted into DC. In rectifiers, we shall discuss single phase half wave rectifiers, both cases, controlled and uncontrolled case, with different kind of loads, R load, RL load and RLE load respectively. And then we shall discuss single phase full wave rectifier, uncontrolled type, control type and semi-controlled type with R load, RL load and RLE load. And then we shall discuss three phase half bridge and full bridge rectifier with, so at least with R load. Finally, we shall also discuss the effect of source impedance on the performance of AC to DC converter, and we shall conclude this particular unit number 2 by discussing dual converter. In third unit, we discuss DC to DC converter, where input for this converter can be fixed or variable type DC, output also can be fixed or variable type DC. In this chapter, we shall discuss elementary DC-DC converter with active switch and diode. We discuss basically concept of duty ratio and average voltage, which forms a basis for analysis and operation of the DC-DC converter. Then we shall discuss power circuits of buck converter, boost converter and buck boost converter in detail. So we shall analyze their operation and the performance in detail for various kinds of loads. And at the end of this particular unit, we shall also briefly introduce isolated DC-DC converters. In fourth chapter, we shall discuss inverters. Inverter is a DC to AC converter which can convert fixed or variable DC into variable voltage and variable frequency type AC. In this chapter, we shall start our discussion with introduction to inverters, single phase voltage source inverters with R load, RL load and RLC loads, three phase voltage source inverter with two modes of operation, 180 degrees and 120 degrees conduction mode of operations, are going to be discussed in detail. And then we will also discuss controlling technique for output voltage of DC to AC converter, that is modulation technique, one of the major technique that is known as modulation technique. In modulation techniques, we shall discuss PWM technique and SPWM techniques. We shall see what PWM, what is SPWM circuit in this particular chapter. So these are techniques that are used to control output voltage of inverter, that is DC to AC converter. And at end of this particular unit, we shall briefly introduce the current source inverter. In unit 5, we are going to discuss AC to AC converter. In AC to AC converters, once again we have classification into two categories. One is AC voltage controller, other one is cycloconverter. AC voltage controller is a converter which converts fixed voltage and fixed frequency AC into variable voltage and fixed frequency AC. And with respect to this particular topic, which we discussed principle of phase control and principle of integral cycle control to have the conversion, that is fixed AC to variable voltage AC. And we shall discuss single phase voltage controllers in detail. Coming to cycloconverter, cycloconverter is a converter which can convert fixed voltage and fixed frequency AC into variable voltage and variable frequency AC. And particular to this topic, we shall see what is principle of cycloconverter operation, and we shall see single phase to single phase cycloconverter and single phase to three phase cycloconverters. And I expect students to have some prerequisite knowledge to understand this course. Basically, I expect students to have knowledge on circuit analysis, such as passive elements, R, L, and C, and basic circuit laws. And I also expect students to have some knowledge on concept of average and RMS values of AC quantities, concept of average power, concept of power factor, active power, and reactive power. Apart from the above, I also expect students to have some knowledge on Fourier analysis, especially Fourier series analysis. And syllabus to be covered is mentioned. Now coming to the textbooks and references, so you can refer these books to for your reference. I recommend students to follow the second textbook, that is Ned Mohan, Power Electronics, Converters, Applications and Design, by Ned Mohan. I recommend you to follow this book or the first book. Of course, you can refer any book, but so this, I prefer this book. So thank you.